He's alone now, asleep. The grizzly waits out the long winter months beneath a canopy of white. Ridges and breaks of snow, capped mountains shelter him from Alaska's harshest bite. The long winter days pass. Patiently, he awaits the thaw. At last, the sun pours its life into a frozen vastness. Rivers rise. Lakes clear their shells of ice, welcoming the fowl to their spring nesting ground. Once again, the rivers sparkle with life, pouring clear water toward the sea. Below, thousands of salmon pass their way north. Spring has arrived, and with it, the arrival of the forest dwellers, eager to begin anew. And with their arrival, so come the hunters. I too am a hunter. It's here that I return to play out the drama that man has rehearsed for a million years. For I am a spear hunter. Primitive, yet lethal. Harvesting the flesh and hide of Alaska's greatest predators. Foraging as my ancestors have for 1,000 centuries.
Wow.
Facing my own fears while facing the beast. I now search the vastness, waiting and wondering where he might be. North America's man-eater. Massive, smart, elusive. He's out there. He's waiting. The Grizz.
I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel targets, Carbon Express arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I light them up with Luminox and wear Mossy Oak camo. I kill animals with Grim Reapers and lure them near with Killer Gear decoys. I use Muzzy for big fish and put their meat in canyon coolers. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough.
Check this bait and nothing's hit it. Spreading it. Add some donuts and some oil and Maybe in a few days they'll pick up the odor and hit it.
Grizzly hunting is a constant search. They're pneumatic beast. Here today, gone tomorrow. It's a daily search for a hot bait.
Wolves have taken over the bait. When the wolves take over, the grizzlies leave.
So we spread the baits miles apart. There's lots of them. We search each bait, hoping that a big boar will take a liking to one of them. And if I'm lucky, he just might come back for seconds. Today, this guy was waiting. He's brave and stupid, but a young boar, maybe 250 pounds. And yep, he could kill you just the same. You can tell by the way he side-eyes me, he don't like me. And the fact that he's here means Big Daddy probably isn't. So it's off searching more baits. A maze of waterways. They intertwine with rising mountains and the vast forest.
One little brown bear. One big brown bear. And a bunch of black bears.
Browns like this bait. But so does a family of four black bears. And they've learned to like me. For I bring dinner.
They own the bait site. Mama bear, she's kind of mean, but she's a good mama. But she's got three brats, and they are ornery. Still no brown bear. Got close last night. But they never finished. The bears keep smelling me. It's hard. Brown bears are harder than a big white tail. Easily harder.
Baby black bears, well, they're not too smart. And each has his own personality. This little chocolate guy is a thief. He likes to steal my cameras. And Blackie, well, I guess you could say he reminds me of myself. Even bear hunting 10 hours a day, for weeks at a time, can start to wear on you. Every now and again, we'd take a break and go rabbit hunting. And calling with the pocket prey is a fun change of pace, for it sure brings in those rabbits.
Guys, Lynn's testing his new crossbow, which is a pretty amazing piece of equipment. You can buy it for under
$200.
Under $200.
Last fall, Tim, I killed two white-tailed deer, a wild boar, and a javelina with it.
Yeah, you can buy a cheap shot crossbow for under $200, and you can kill anything you need with it. You know, we're not all out there making tons of money, so it's kind of nice to be able to afford to have some cool equipment and go hunting and enjoy the sport of chasing rabbits and deer and everything else.
This is so much fun. This crossbow is so much fun, you're gonna have to have one.
Yeah, you need to grow up, Lynn.
Never.
So Lynn got this rabbit, you know, right, ooh, got him in the ten ring, and shot him with his wrecking ball. Ooh, that's a fat rabbit there. That's a fat one, Lynn.
And these things are really good eating. My plan, if we get enough of them, is to smoke them. One of the PHs here, Aaron, that owns the outfit, he is the smoking fool.
You kill them, you gotta eat them. So, cleaning rabbits.
Okay guys, all you gotta do is slock a rabbit, dress it out, a little bit of rib rub, 2 hours in the smoker at about 200 degrees. Look at this, we even got a fire going in there. It shouldn't be doing that. But we're done, so we can take them out now.
Ooh, just missed that first one. They're fast. But here comes another one now.
Here I am with my master grizzly bear guide. Been slow the last 2 days, so he keeps his clients happy. And I'm happy, 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 Aaron.
Totally white in the wintertime, just like their belly, the whole rabbit will be white. A month ago, it was brown up here. We had an early spring, and there were like light bulbs running through the woods.
Wasn't the best 10-ring shot.
That's the first shot, yeah.
That's a -5, but it killed him.
The second one got him,
I think. Hit him in the kidney that first shot, but it immobilized him. I mean, he wasn't going nowhere.
Cool.
All right, let's go get another one.
Great.
Here we are, Jerry. Me and you again, honey.
Just me and you, Tim. We will do this.
Trust me, honey. She's hot, but I'm loyal.
I'm loyal.
Did a lot of work darting those rabbits with my blowgun. I sure hope this turns out good.
I will make it worth your while.
Okay. We're cooking with bacon grease now.
Yep. Breaded rabbit and squirrel. Just frying it.
Alright, so now we're mixing everything together. It's kind of like a Alaskan porridge, right?
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
Well, here we are. Having a rabbit in my vegetables right before I go after a brown bear. Mmm, delicious.
You don't want to get in the water here. Swift coming off those mountains. Snow melts, rushes down here. Salmon rush upstream. You fall in the river, you rush downstream.
My two guides, Aaron and Casey, camp cooks, and staff, all have logged hundreds of hours, all for what? For me, and the hope that I could spear a grizzly. I'd be lying if I said I didn't feel the pressure. If I get the chance, I sure hope I make it count. The vastness of Alaska seems lonely at times, yet peaceful. As in the days before, my guide jumps from the boat, then goes to check trail cameras to see if anything's visited the bait. I wait in the boat to reduce the amount of scent we spread near the bait. The report is good, for they have arrived. Alaska's monsters. At 3 a.m., 2 days before, they were here. I grab my climber and head in for the night. This night started out no different than many others. Lonely and quiet. A resting forest all around me. Then, in the wee hours of the morning, it all changed.
Awesome.
Awesome bear. Mean bear.
Mixing everything together. It's kind of like a Alaskan porridge, right?
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
Here I am with my master grizzly bear guide. Been slow the last 2 days, so he keeps his clients happy. And I'm happy, Aaron.